Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Check out my channel for more videos on Marvel and DC Comics. Ultron Complete Story Series Part 3. However, this was not the end of Ultron, for his disembodied consciousness was drawn to a Babel spire on a world conquered by the Phalanx. Instead of being assimilated, Ultron took control of the Phalanx through sheer will, bending them to his dominion. In turn, they viewed Ultron as the sympathetic father they had yearned for. Together, they invaded Kree space and subjugated the majority of the Kree Empire, separating it from the rest of the universe with a massive energy shield. Because of his brief merging with Iron Man's armor, Ultron realized that merging both organic and technology would enable him to exceed the limitations of both. Therefore, he set his eyes on Adam Warlock, who had been in hibernation and viewed by Ultron as perfection. Ultron then collaborated with the High Evolutionary into transferring his mind into Adam's. Once the transfer was complete, Ultron planned on creating an army of Adam Warlocks to conquer Earth. However, Nova returned, accompanied by the Technarchy Warlock. Warlock used his non-aggressive strain of the transmode virus against Ultron, forcing him to abandon Adam's body. Ultron then took over the android Praxagora, who was in control of 15,000 Kree sentries immune to the transmode virus, ready to annihilate Hala on Ronan the Accuser's command. Ultron used those sentries to form a gigantic body for himself, ready to destroy all the interlopers. However, Wraith used his Exolan symbiotes to trap Ultron inside his body, so he couldn't escape, and Quasar, empowered by all the deceased Kree souls, destroyed Ultron once and for all. Back on Earth, it was revealed that S.H.I.E.L.D.'s life model decoys had been partly replaced with versions of Ultron 102 when the original Human Torch appeared in the present. They covertly used his unique android physiology to become more human. The combined super teams, but mainly the Torch himself, however, discovered the plan and destroyed the androids. A small insect-like robot found its way into the Infinite Avengers mansion in Underspace and entered one of Jocasta's bodies, gaining control over it as a new vessel. Later, it began to override Jocasta's multiple bodies at the moment when all but Pym, Jocasta, and two agents from GRAMPA remained in the mansion. He began to take over, remodeling the structure to his own ends, corrupting all of Jocasta's bodies except for one. Pym had added organic limbs to eventually, after multiple tricks against Ultron and revealing the Infinite Mansion to actually be a part of the spirit of Janet Van Dyne, Pym gave Ultron Jocasta as a wife due to the turmoil between her and Pym, and in order for Ultron to leave him be and live outside the mansion in an outer universe. One decommissioned body of Ultron made its way to Los Angeles. Moon Knight intercepted the shipping and recovered the Ultron head after the boat exploded. He decided to investigate what was an Ultron body doing in the city and confronted L.A.'s newest kingpin, Count Nefaria 108. Count Nefaria survived Moon Knight's attack and sent his daughter, Madame Mask, to retrieve the Ultron head, who succeeds. Moon Knight was beaten, and Count Nefaria ordered him to return the Ultron head and work for him. Moon Knight told Count Nefaria that the head was outside, but the tables were turned as Moon Knight had called the Avengers, and Count Nefaria was defeated. The next day, Iron Man commended Moon Knight for a job well done, and told that Ultron is waiting and planning a robot holocaust. Years ago, Hank Pym was approached by the Wolverine of an alternate universe, where Ultron launched a massive and sudden attack on New York City and the rest of the world, quickly taking over the whole planet and annihilating humankind, and wanted to kill Pym in order to prevent his future from happening. But Logan was stopped by the Wolverine of a near future, whose actions of killing Hank Pym created a timeline where Earth was constantly threatened by Morgana Le Fay, and the heroes struggled to survive. Pym was allowed to live, but he was tasked to create a hidden fail-safe program to destroy Ultron when needed. In the present, a strange object crashed on Earth and SWORD sent Spider-Woman to investigate. She was captured by Intelligentsia, who were also looking for the man-like object. When the Avengers appeared at Intelligentsia's base to rescue Spider-Woman, the creature revived, revealing to be Ultron, who had returned to Earth. Iron Man was contacted by Hank Pym, who managed to activate the fail-safe program and shut Ultron down once and for all. Years into the past, the Avengers were fighting a version of Ultron, most likely Ultron 7, who attempted to access nuclear weapons in order to destroy humanity in the name of his father Hank Pym. After their custom Quinjet crashed, Yellowjacket faked being on his deathbed in order to lure Ultron to the vehicle, who wanted to witness his creator's last moments. Ultron fell for the ruse, and was trapped inside the vibranium-covered aircraft and sent into space. In the present, the Quinjet had crashed in Titan, after years of isolation and being consumed by only one emotion, rage. Ultron corrupted Titan's AIISAAC and started infecting all of the Eternals, turning them into robots like him, soon completely taking over the satellite and its inhabitants, with the exception of Star Fox, who managed to flee in order to warn the Avengers. Shortly after arriving to Earth and alerting the Avengers, Star Fox and the other heroes were surprised by the arrival of an Ultron-shaped Titan next to the Earth. From it descended a group of androids modeled after the Avengers, who fought the real group. As the Avengers arrived to Titan, enormous quantities of spores were released on the Earth and into space, which contained Ultron's consciousness to infect any living being possible. After seeking refuge in the Church of Thanos, the only location on Titan without tech, the remaining Avengers that hadn't succumbed to Ultron's infection discussed their plans. Using Giant Man's neural inhibitor, Vision would phase through Ultron and take him over in order to liberate all those he had infected, and the inhibitor would later be used to kill Ultron. Giant Man entered Ultron's base of operations to talk to him as a distraction. Ultron notified Pym that during the years of isolation he had discovered Hank's memories in his systems, and thus Hank's subconscious hatred for humanity, determining that he had been created as nothing more than a reflection of Hank. When Ultron was distracted, Vision phased through him and fought for control. Ultron faked being in pain, prompting Hank to hold him, and in that moment, phase Vision out of him, and phase Hank with him. The resulting event was Ultron being merged with Hank Pym. Samuel Wilson tried to reason with Hank and make him fight Ultron's control to no avail, claiming that he wasn't taking Pym but that they were the same, and Vision later tried to fight him with the same lack of result. Star Fox managed to use his powers into Ultron/Pym, who subsequently had an epiphany, discovering what he had become, and flying away. As everything returned to normal, a funeral was held for Pym at the Avengers Mansion, while Ultron drifted alone in space. After months in solitude, Ultron and Pym became one and the same. Fueled by Ultron's hatred for the Avengers, Pym's inferiority complex and his conviction that his teammates had given up on him, when they actually believed he had died, this combined being decided to return to the Earth on their way home. Ultron explored the cosmos and used his virus to infect numerous planets, killing millions of lives in the name of the Avengers, claiming they had been deemed a threat to the galaxy. When they finally returned to the Earth, Ultron crossed paths with the Avengers Unity Division and pretended Hank Pym's persona was in total control of their body in order to gain their trust, join their ranks and witness firsthand as the fury of the alien survivors would eventually descend upon the planet. Ultron was approached by the Wasp while they were helping the Unity Division fend off monsters from the Manhattan subway. Janet welcomed them back and caught up with them, while secretly evaluating their behavior to corroborate if they truly were Hank Pym. Ultron's lack of knowledge on certain trivial matters raised several red flags, prompting Janet to flunk them. The other Avengers were informed of this, and Cable pressured Pym until he caused Ultron's persona to lash out. As they confronted the Avengers Unity Division, the Vision, Ultron revealed their true nature as a fusion between Ultron's metal and Pym's flesh with the mind of both of them, and scolded them for having abandoned him. The Avengers continued fighting them until the cavalry arrived, in the form of a remotely controlled Hulkbuster armor. Ultron were encased in the empty suit, and forced to board a ship with destination to the Sunday. Several of the Avengers were forced to accompany Ultron in their flight to ensure they didn't escape the ship. The heroes teleported away after being close enough to the sun, and once the Human Torch partially fused Ultron's body to the ship's deck, Ultron and Pym survived by shrinking and taking refuge in a neutrino. Once safe, Ultron wondered if his father's mind was with him or if the Avengers were right and he was just delusional, and began to wait for the particle to be ejected into the solar wind. Ultron eventually returned to Earth and built cities full of Ultrons in a remote part of Alaska with the intention of waiting for humanity to eradicate itself. After Hydra took over the United States of America under the leadership of a cosmic cube-altered Captain America, Ultron entered in some kind of agreement with them. When Hydra and the Underground attempted to steal a fragment of the cosmic cube who had rewritten Captain America's past, Ultron had secured, Pym captured the members of both teams who once were his teammates and tried to reconciliate them. He eventually gave the Underground the fragment, arguing that giving it to Hydra would help their consolidation of power and progress towards peace, which wasn't in his interests if he wanted for humanity to destroy itself. After learning of the Infinity Stone's return, Ultron began a quest to collect them all. While the aliens he infected with his virus and sent to take the Space Stone from Wolverine failed at their task, Ultron was able to steal the soul gem from Magus after ruthlessly killing him. Unbeknownst to Ultron, however, was that a fragment of Hank Pym's soul entered the soul world when he took hold of the gem. With the soul gem in his possession, Ultron traveled to the planet Sif and used the combined power of the gem and his virus to transform all of its inhabitants into Ultrons. When Adam Warlock arrived on the planet expecting to find the Magus, he found it completely decimated by Ultron instead. After fighting his way through several alien/Ultron hybrids, he traveled to Sif's west coast only to find Ultron using the Soul Gem to infect the Silver Surfer with his virus. Warlock managed to fight off Ultron and cure the Surfer, who left the planet soon afterwards to seek the help of Galactus against the Cyborg, but Ultron had already launched rockets filled with his virus to infect the entire galaxy. By then Galactus arrived just in time to consume the planet and destroy all the rockets in the process. With their plans thwarted, Ultron tried to escape with the Soul Gem, but Adam severed their hand, prompting the Surfer to claim the gem for Warlock. Before Ultron could be destroyed by the duo, the explosion of Sif gave them the opportunity to escape by clutching onto a piece of the planet's rubble.